10 disasters that could erase humanity from Earth. Since the beginning of civilization, preventing natural calamities has been a difficult task for humanity. Whether the end of our days arrives sooner or later, humanity must confront some fairly bleak possibilities. Have you ever questioned if humans could live on Earth in the future? In this video, we look at several catastrophes that could wipe out all life on Earth. It does not help that practically all life on Earth is being badly disrupted by human activity. Approximately 108 billion people have ever lived, and Pamlin and Armstrong predict that 3 quadrillion people will ever exist if humanity continues to exist for another 50 million years. Although that is a positive appraisal of the future of humanity, it also implies that if something were to cause human extinction, there would be great moral suffering. Taking precautions against situations that have a remote chance of triggering such is worthwhile. It may seem safe to live on our small blue planet before you realize what dangers are out there. In this video, we will look at 10 natural disasters that might drive humanity off the planet. Please give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to this channel for more stuff before we continue. Click the bell icon to receive notifications when new videos are posted. Have you already executed it? Let us get started. Number 10, Asteroid Effect. It's challenging to take a catastrophic scenario seriously once it has been given the corny Hollywood treatment. We will not have to wait millions of years for a cosmic intrusion to strike Earth, but that much is certain. A 200-foot-wide comet fragment burst in 1908 over the Tunguska region of Siberia, Russia, with an energy level of almost 1,000 times greater than the atomic bomb that destroyed Hiroshima. According to astronomers, similar-sized events happen once to 3 centuries. In England's Liverpool John Moores University, anthropologist and pessimist Benny Pizer asserts that environmental effects have repeatedly uprooted human civilization. He uses the killing of 10,000 people in the Chinese city of Qingyang in 1490 as an example. Many scientists contest his interpretations. Smaller impacts over land are more likely to harm sparsely populated areas. In contrast, larger ones are more likely to occur over the ocean. However, it's fine where large asteroids land. Around once every 250,000 years, objects larger than a half mile wide would strike Earth, setting off firestorms and causing the planet to cool due to the dust the impact would produce. The likelihood of human survival is high, but society may not. Major extinctions like the one that may have signaled the end of the dinosaur era would be brought on by an asteroid 5 miles wide. Number 9, Gamma Ray Burst. Astrophysicists recently discovered that these gamma ray bursts come from far-off galaxies and are insanely powerful, up to 10 quadrillion times as energetic as the Sun. The merger of 2 collapsed stars most likely causes the explosions. Such a twin star may be almost entirely undetected before the catastrophic event. Therefore, we may not be aware if one is nearby in advance. However, once the blast is started, it would be impossible to avoid its cruelty. It would look roughly as bright as the Sun at a distance of 1,000 light years, which is farther than most of the stars you can see on a clear night. The burst's lethal X and gamma rays would initially be mostly shielded from us by Earth's atmosphere, but at a cost. The powerful radiation's ability to fry the atmosphere and produce nitrogen oxides would destroy the ozone layer. Without the ozone layer, the Sun's ultraviolet rays would almost completely penetrate the atmosphere, causing skin cancer and, more seriously, wiping out the tiny photosynthetic plankton in the ocean that supports the base of the food chain and produce oxygen for the atmosphere. Number 8. The Vacuum Collapses. According to a leading cosmological hypothesis, energy-filled space is very early in the universe's history. Like Ice 9, a more stable vacuum appeared and swiftly took over. A great quantity of energy was released during this transition, leading to a sudden runaway expansion of the cosmos. However, there is likely a different, even more stable type of vacuum. Tiny bubbles of this novel type of vacuum may develop and spread almost as quickly as light as the universe enlarges and cools. In their wake, the laws of physics would be altered, and a burst of energy would obliterate everything. Number 7. Exceptional black holes. Black holes are regions of space with a such intense gravitational pull that light cannot escape from them and that they draw other objects into their gravitational clutches. The amount of mass packed into a small region determines the strength of the gravitational force. Black holes form when a star is about to die. Black holes do not always signal their direction. Even without entering Earth's orbit, a black hole may still cause a catastrophe. Our planet's orbit and those of other planets could be altered by just traveling through the solar system. That would have severe effects on the climate. The planet Earth may be pulled onto an elliptical route that would result in drastic climate changes, or it may be ejected from the solar system and speed toward a freezing doom in the reaches of outer space. Recently, David Bennett of Notre Dame University in Indiana discovered two black holes by observing how they twisted and amplified the light from common, farther off stars. Researchers estimate that there are roughly 10 million black holes in the Milky Way based on these observations and even more on theoretical justifications. One of these objects is hardly expected to pass close to Earth because they orbit like other stars. However, we would be aware if a typical star were heading in our direction. A black hole offers little forewarning. At most, scientists might spot an odd disruption of the outer planet's orbits a few decades before a close encounter. It would be feasible to determine the interloper's mass and location with increasing accuracy as the influence grew. Number 6. Giant solar flares. Massive magnetic surges from the sun, known as solar flares, bombard the Earth with subatomic particles. Our atmosphere and the Earth's magnetic field protect us from the effects of typical flares. The ozone layer could begin to disappear due to so-called superflares, millions of times more intense than common ones. Fortunately, no proof exists that our sun has ever behaved that way. The strongest solar storm ever recorded in 1859 destroyed telegraph lines, the age's equivalent of the internet, and caused them to catch fire. The largest solar flare ever recorded was recorded in 2003, although it occurred at an angle that allowed Earth to escape its full force. Solar flares have recently caused power outages in several parts of the planet. Number 5. Earth's magnetic field reverses. Every few hundred thousand years, for perhaps a century, Earth's magnetic field gradually vanishes, only to gradually resurface with the North and South poles reversed. We might be past due, as the last time this happened was 780,000 years ago. Even worse, during the past century, the intensity of our magnetic field has reduced by around 5%. Also, the magnetic field refracts much more energetic subatomic particles from deep space, as are solar cosmic rays and particle storms. Without magnetic shieldings, these particles would collide with the atmosphere of the Earth and erode the already vulnerable ozone layer. Additionally, many species use magnetic navigation. A magnetic reversal might seriously harm the environment. One major caveat: according to Sten Odenwald of the NASA Goddard Space Flight Center, there are no discernible fossil consequences from past flips. This is quite curious. Even so, a catastrophe like the Black Plague in Europe, which killed a quarter of the populace, would rarely be noted in the fossil record. Number 4. Flood-Basalt Volcanism. The Laki volcano in Iceland erupted in 1783, spewing 3 cubic miles of lava into the air. 9,000 people were killed by floods, ash, and gases, while 80% of the cattle perished. A fourth of Iceland's population perished from the ensuing hunger. The newly founded United States experienced a 9-degree drop in winter temperatures due to atmospheric dust. According to scientists, a supervolcanic eruption larger than Krakatoa, Mount St. Helens, or Vesuvius is overdue. much larger. According to scientific theories, such an occurrence might release enormous amounts of debris into the atmosphere and lower the Earth's temperature. Only a few weeks or months' notice before a catastrophic volcanic eruption may be given to humans. It might have come from Yellowstone Park. There was a significant eruption there more than 600,000 years ago. Sulfurous volcanic gases cause acid rain. Chlorine-containing substances are a poisonous brew that constantly threatens the ozone layer. Volcanoes produce not only immediate destruction, but also long-term warming due to the release of carbon dioxide. The Columbia River Plateau was created by the last significant flood-basalt volcanism pulse about 17 million years ago. We are ready for more. Number 3. Nuclear war. The good news in this situation is that only very specific conditions would make nuclear war inevitable. Even if there were only a few exchanges, like the bombs of Hiroshima and Nagasaki by the US during World War II, there would still be humanitarian tragedies and little chance of eradicating humanity. Even exchanges that are much bigger fall short of having the impact that Pamlin and Armstrong demand. Even if the entire populations of Europe, Russia, and the United States were directly wiped out in a nuclear war, an outcome that some studies have shown to be physically impossible given population dispersion and the number of missiles in existence, that would not raise the war to the first level of impact, which requires greater than 2 billion affected. Pamlin and Armstrong write. Therefore, why does nuclear war appear on this list? Due to the potential for nuclear winter. In other words, if enough nuclear weapons are used, the global temperature would decrease sharply and quickly, affecting the ability to produce food and possibly ending human life. It's unclear if it's even feasible or how huge of a conflict you would need to start, but if it is, it means that a massive nuclear exchange might wipe out humanity. Number 2. Global warming. Most scientists concur that people are somewhat to blame for the Earth's warming. It's simple to understand how climate change could cause cities to flood and crop failure. In recent years, scientists like Paul Epstein of Harvard Medical School have sounded the alarm that a warmer globe could also aid in the development of infectious disease by creating a climate that is more conducive to parasites and the spread of a variety of tropical viruses. That might include crop illness that could lead to famine combined with significant climate changes. The results may be more striking. Atmospheric gases trap enough heat near the surface to maintain a comfortable environment. However, suppose the world's temperature rises somewhat. In that case, there may be a negative feedback loop whereby quicker water evaporation releases water vapor. This powerful greenhouse gas traps more heat and releases carbon dioxide into the atmosphere, raising temperatures even further. Earth might resemble Venus, where the daily high temperature is 900 degrees Fahrenheit, although it would likely take a significant amount of warmth to start such a runaway greenhouse effect. Experts are still determining exactly where the tipping point is. Number 1. Ecosystem collapse. Because of human activities, at least 30,000 species every year become extinct, placing us in the midst of one of the biggest mass extinction events in Earth's history. The delicate checks and balances in the larger ecology could be upset in several ways, according to Yale University's Stephen Kellert, a social ecologist. He asserts that the emergence of novel disease patterns or the extinction of pollinating insects could result in widespread crop failure. Alternatively, similar to the Isle Royale wolves, the implications might be something we could only consider once it was too late. The video for today has concluded. Give the channel a thumbs up and subscribe if you enjoyed the video. Remember to click the bell icon to get alerts when new videos are posted. In the future video, we will meet. Bye for now.